Welcome back, and in stage 5 of this advanced demo series, we're going to clean up the account and return it to the same state as it was at the start. The first step is to move to the EC2 console, so click on Services, type EC2, and then click to move to the console. Just move to Running Instances, select the AWS CatWeb instance, so this is the one that you provisioned manually, right click, and then just go ahead and terminate the instance. Next, click on Services and move to the RDS console. The instance itself will take a while to delete, so we need to click on Databases, select the instance, and then go to Actions and Delete. We won't be creating a final snapshot, so untick that box. Uncheck Retain Automated Backups. You'll need to check that you acknowledge upon instance deletion that backups will be removed, and then you'll need to type Delete Me into the box to confirm, and then go ahead and delete the instance. Now at this point, you'll need to wait for this deletion process to complete before continuing with the next steps. So go ahead and pause the video and wait for this RDS instance to disappear, and then we can carry on. Once that's deleted, go to Subnet Groups, select A4LDBSN Group, and then go ahead and delete it. Next, click on Services and move to the DMS console, so Database Migration Service. Go to Database Migration Tasks and select the task that you created earlier, A4L On-Prem to AWS WordPress, and then go ahead and delete that. Then select Replication Instances and select the replication instance that you created earlier, A4L On-Prem to AWS, and go ahead and delete that. If you get an error message saying failed to delete this, then that's because the task hasn't completed deleting, so you'll need to wait for that to finish. You can go ahead and try it again after a few moments, and it should start deleting. Next, go to Endpoints, and select each of these in turn and delete them. So that's deleting both A4L WordPress and CatDB on-premises. Now you'll need to wait for the replication instance to complete deleting before you can complete the next step. So go ahead and pause the video and wait for this to vanish from the list, and then we can continue. Once that vanishes from the list, you can go to Subnet Groups, select A4L DMS SN Group, and then go ahead and delete that. Next, we need to remove the VPC peer between the two VPCs, so click on Services, and then move to the VPC console. Once there, we're going to go to Route Tables, select each of these route tables, click on Routes, Edit Routes, and then remove the route that you added pointing at the VPC peer, and this starts with PCX, so we delete that. So that was on-prem public RT. Next, let's do the AWS private route table with the same process. So edit routes, delete the route starting PCX. We'll do the same with the public route table for the AWS environment. So select it, edit, delete the PCX targeted route, save. And that's all three of those route tables done. So next, click on peering connections. Make sure you've got the right peering connection selected. You should only have one, but it's the one between the on-premises and AWS environment. So select that and then just go ahead and delete it. Once that's deleted, the final step is to move to the CloudFormation console. There'll be the DMS stack that you created using the one-click deploy at the start of the demo series. Just go ahead and select it and then delete it. And once it's deleted, your account will be back in the same state as it was at the start of the demo series with no leftover resources. And at this point, that's the end of this advanced demo series. You've successfully implemented the architecture that's shown on screen now. So I hope it's been fun, I hope it's been enjoyable, and I hope you've gained practical experience of how to use DMS. Now, this has been a simple example, but it's one where the skills that you've learned will be equally as applicable with large complex migrations. But at this point, that's everything that I wanted you to cover, so go ahead, complete this video, and I hope that you'll join me soon in another exciting advanced demo series.